Prince's dream had given the hero some insight to what was troubling young Selius. Once the dream ended, the heroes woke up at the edge of a forest with the pale moon shining on them. They spied a narrow trail leading into the dark forest. In the distance, the nightmare wolves kept howling.
About we let the boy run. It's his life. And it's not like we're getting anything out of this little field trip, except a pat on the back from the wizards.
Leave the boy alone? In a nighttime forest full of nightmares?
And what if some innocent bystanders run into those monsters?
Stones.
Must be some kind of ancient magic lingering in these ruins.
Let's see what this magic can do.
Amadeus was so scared of. She reminds me of someone.
You don't say.
Oh, I really can't put my finger on who it was.
Amadeus, how is Margaret?
Oh, the usual. Business is booming, I hear.
Thank you.
It seems irreparable. Too bad. Interesting moths in this forest.
That thing up there, that was no moth.
Oh, this forest must be enchanted.
Well, a letter from Linus.
Thank you.
I do like romantic candlelight. Selius manages to conjure up all our nightmares.
Then we'll face them like we did with your Aunt Gretchen.
The prince can't conjure a single creature that can scare me. Someone's in trouble.